I am now going to demonstrate the tests which are to be performed if you are suspecting a sacroiliac joint pathology, maybe tuberculosis of the sacroiliac joint, or in the elderly patient, sometimes we have sacroiliac osteoarthritis. So the first step would be to identify the sacroiliac joint by palpation with the patient in the prone position and to see whether the sacroiliac joint is tender or not. So in lean and thin patients, we have the dimple of venous, which may be corresponding to the sacroiliac joint. Otherwise, if you are finding it difficult or if the patient is obese, then you can trace the iliac crest posteriorly, reach the posterior superior iliac spine, and just inferior and medial to it would lie the sacroiliac joint. So if the sacroiliac joint on thumb pressure, direct anterior thumb pressure, the patient winces, then the sacroiliac joint is tender. This, for comparison's sake, should be tested on both the sides, and then a final decision should be made, because sometimes the pressure may be too much and the patient may wince on both the sides. So this is usually a comparative test to pick up sacroiliac pathology. Once the tenderness is positive, or otherwise, if you want to further probe the sacroiliac joint, you need to perform certain tests which can be performed either in the prone position. One of them can be performed in the prone position, so we'll perform it right here. This goes by the name of prone hyperextension test, where you can flex the knee to 90 degrees, hold the leg as a handle, put your palm on the iliac crest to stabilize the pelvis, and then you do a prone hyperextension test. So the idea is that this would impart a sort of a torsional stress onto the sacroiliac joint and the patient may wince. The other standard tests are the pump handle test and the stretching in the figure of 8 movement, and that can be tested in the supine position. So we need to put the patient in the supine position. Insofar as the pump handle test is concerned, it is very easy to perform. You need to flex the knee fully, the hip is to be flexed to 90 degrees, and hereafter you stabilize the contralateral shoulder. Once you stabilize the contralateral shoulder, you try to give a jerk towards the opposite shoulder, and if the patient winces, then the pump handle test is positive. The same maneuver can be repeated on the other side, because certain patients, like ankylosing spondylitis patients, may be having a bilateral sacroiliitis. So in the same way, flex the knee fully, hold the proximal tibia, stabilize the contralateral shoulder, and you give a jerk while fully flexing the hip towards the opposite shoulder. In case the test is positive, it indicates active sacroiliac inflammation or arthritis. Thank you. Another test which can delineate sacroiliac pathology goes by the name of figure of 4 test, where you flex the knee to about 90 degrees, and then thereafter you externally rotate the hip, and if the patient has pain while forceful external rotation, then this test is positive.